Good morning.
Good morning and welcome again to Morning Devotional. We just thank the Lord again that we are able to come and do Morning Devotional and enjoy another day in the Lord.
Yes, we are so happy to be here with you this morning and share the word again with your brothers and sisters. The Lord said we're two or more together. Come together in my name on the same accord. I am in
the midst. Amen.
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 And so we are here to share the word of God this morning.
Give you some devotional, some good bread of life to start your day off.
Yes.
So we're going to start off with a little bit of worship, and we'll come back and talk about Morning Devotional, right here on L.P.J. 64 with Mr. and Mrs. Sweetbang.
Are filled with expectation. They are filled with love and a passion for you. We have a hunger and a thirst that only you can satisfy.
Lord, we enter this moment with anticipation. We know that in your presence, bodies are healed, broken dreams are restored, and lives are transformed. Because with you, all things are possible.
Lord, we say, as we worship, you are welcome here.
Consume us.
Change us.
Give us visions and dreams.
Give us your heart for the nations.
Give us your heart for this generation.
And Father, let our generation arise and demonstrate the kind of selfless faith that will change the world. Let a generation emerge that will manifest your love in the earth so that all will come to know you.
As we worship, let your presence fill this room. Release signs, wonders, and miracles. We'll be changed.
We expect an encounter with you.
And we know we'll never be the same as we worship.
As we worship.
As we worship.
I wonder, are you on your way? I wonder.
You are listening to L.P.J. 64 with Mr. and Mrs. Sweet Thing Morning Devotional.
Hey, man, you know we can't ever go before the Lord without prayer.
Amen.
So let's have a moment of prayer this morning.
Yeah.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning just thanking you, Lord, for giving us another day of life. We know that this day would not exist if it wasn't for your grace and mercy. So we just thank you, Lord, for lifting us to the floor this morning, Lord, giving us this day. Lord, we ask you to go before us this morning, wherever we go, and make the way. We know the way could not help. Been there if you didn't go before.
Mm-hmm.
So go before us, Lord. Make our way. Lead us to this day. Lord, let us walk behind you. So when we get there, we'll know the way have already been made.
Mm-hmm.
We know if you make the way, no one can undo it. So, Lord, we just thank you for giving us what has been given to us in this day this morning.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you for all things, Lord. We just thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for that prayer, Mr. Sweet Thing. And this morning we're going to be talking about the test of character. This is coming from Malachi chapter 3 and verse 3. Malachi chapter 3 and verse 3 says, "And he shall sit as a refiner and purify fire of silver. He shall purify the sons of Levi and purge them as gold and silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness." Well, you know, many who profess sanctification are entirely ignorant of the work of grace upon the heart.
Amen.
You know, they lay aside reason and judgment and depend wholly upon their feelings. And that's right. And basing their claims to sanctification upon emotions which they have at some time experienced. Bible sanctification does not consist in strong emotion, and it doesn't. That is correct.
Well, excuse me, you know the Lord tells us not to go on our feelings, neither what we think, but only what the Holy Spirit tells us.
That's correct.
And when we start leaning on what we feel and what we think, that's going to get us into trouble. Because now we're leaning on the other master, the devil.
Because he's saying about our hearts are so desperately wicked, who can know them? That's why
you
say that.
Thank you. So that's who you're leaning on. You're leaning on the devil word because you're speaking from your heart and your feelings, which is so evil. That you don't even know it.
That's why that's why you say here's where many are led in error. They make feelings their criteria. When they feel elated or happy, they claim that they are sanctified. Happy feelings or the absence of joy is no evidence that a person is or is not sanctified. So feelings don't have anything to do with sanctification. And those who are battling with daily temptations, overcoming their own sinful tendencies, and seeking for holiness of heart and life, make no boastful claims of holiness. You're right.
That's right.
We are just, you know, really they are hungry and thirsting for righteousness. Sin appears to them exceedingly sinful. Because what he's saying is, you know, each day that we are battling with temptation, and we overcoming the tendency of sin. We just want to overcome sin. And it's sin is so horrifying that you just continue to pray and ask the Lord to give you victory. Because that is a battle for each and every one of us, correct?
Right. And this is what we have to understand. That's why he says it's a battle to
every day.
To your grave. You're battling sin to your grave. You'll overcome sin only when you enter the kingdom. Then the end is over because sin exists no more.
Exactly. And you are right.
See, we have to understand as Christians, the difference in Christians and sinners is sin does not have
control, dominion
over you.
That's right.
Not that you have won over sin, but sin do not control you anymore.
Amen.
That you have a defense against sin, it doesn't knock you down and win the battle every time.
Amen.
See, this is what we have to understand as Christians. Not that you are above sin, but sin don't win every time.
That's
right. You got a defense against it. And that's what we have to understand that God has given us, that we can walk away from sin now. We don't always have to walk into sin.
Amen. I love that. Mm-hmm.
That's what we have to understand as Christians.
Is
that we're not better than others and we don't sin.
Amen.
But where they can't walk away,
we can. Only through Christ Jesus.
Only through Christ
Jesus. The blood of the Lamb.
That's right. That's what we have that they don't have. And we got Jesus.
That's right.
And we can walk away. God give us a door that we can walk out.
We got an escape.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And that's what we have that they don't have. So that's what God is telling us.
Yeah.
That I give you a way out, my child, that sinners don't have because they don't know me.
Amen.
Now, when they become to know me, I will give them a way out too. And that's the difference in being a child of God and not a child of God. And Satan knows that.
Yeah,
he knows if you don't know God, you have no way out.
Mm.
But if you know God, God has got a million doors for you to walk out.
And there's always hope.
And there's always hope.
You know, and that is so true. You know, in the summer months, as we look upon the trees of the distant forest, all are clothed with a beautiful manner of green. We may not be able to distinguish between the evergreens and the other trees, but you know, as winter approaches and the forest king encloses them in his icy embrace, stripping the other trees of their beautiful foliage, the evergreens are readily discerned. Now, thus it will be with all who are walking in humility, distrustful of self, but clinging, trembling to the hand of Christ, while those who are self-confident and trust in their own perfection of character lose their false robe of righteousness when subjected to the storms of trial. The truly righteous, who sincerely love and fear God, they wear the robe of Christ's righteousness in prosperity and in adversity alike.
Amen.
So it doesn't matter what the storms may blow, they still got the robe of righteousness that we just talked about, the tree. You know which one is which when winter hits and one is stripped of its green leaves and other ones still have the beauty of the green foliage.
Now see, that's what you have when you're walking with Christ.
Mm-hmm.
See, when you're not walking with Christ, you don't have those kind of things. See, God give you things when you're walking with Him, that when you're not walking with Him, when you're not walking with Him, you don't have those things. See, God gives His people things that you do not have when you're out there on your own thinking you know what you're doing. God said, come in, let me give you something to keep you protected. And that's why you need to walk with Jesus so you can be protected.
Doing that testing time.
And that's why you need to turn your life around so God can put his hand on you.
Amen.
And keep you protected. That's why it's so important to be a part of the family.
Amen.
Not that you won't fall and God have to pick you back up. That means to be picked up, you have to repent.
Amen.
He don't pick you up unless you repent. Now, you repent, he'll pick you up. And if you don't repent on your own, he'll send you something to help you repent.
Mm-hmm.
He's a loving God. He wants you to repent so bad that if you don't, he'll send a storm that will make you repent. And Lord, you don't want him to send that storm to make you repent. Because sometimes that storm is so rough, you wish you had a went on and repented on your own.
Because when it does, it strips you from the false road, because you wasn't sanctified at that time in the first place.
That's right, that's right. Because if you had been sanctified at that beginning, he wouldn't have to send the storm.
That's right. That's
you would have did it on your own. You would have got up and said, Lord, the devil got me again, and I'm asking you to forgive me, because Lord, I sin against you again, and I'm asking you for your mercy to forgive me. If you know him, that's what you'll do, and won't have no shame in your game. You'll be so happy that you did it, because you know he's worthy.
That's right.
He's worthy for my repentance.
Amen.
No one is worthy but him. And that's when you know that you love him and he's worthy of every bit of it.
That's right.
That's when you know it. You don't have to second guess.
No, you don't.
Because you know he's worthy. Amen to that.
Amen. You know, it requires a testing time to reveal the pure gold of love and faith in the character. When trials and perplexity come upon the church, then the steadfast zeal and warm affections of Christ's true followers are developed. That's when they are developed. And we have to remember that as we continue to walk in Christ, spiritually, and trusting not in ourselves, but only in Christ.
Only.
Then the character is being revealed.
Right. Only in Christ. Not anything. Not ourselves, not our job, not our money, not our cars, not our home, not our brothers, mama, sister, daddies. Only Christ.
So in other words, as we continue to walk by faith, not by sight, we are being transformed into Christ's character.
That's right. That's the only one, Christ himself.
So we just want to thank you this morning for a morning devotional, that you may be encouraged, that you may continue to stay in the Word and continue in prayer so that you can be transformed into his character day by day, moment by moment.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And may the windows of heaven open and pour upon you a bundle of blessings, and have a great morning.
And may God keep you throughout the rest of the day.
Yeah.
Anyhow, my Lord. Close.
mind, all of our soul, Lord. Ah, yes. Oh, we lift our hands and adore you. We worship you and adore you, Lord. Oh, yeah.